Hello everyone, my name is Diyanti Dave, clinical instructor from Dinsha Patel College of Nursing, Nadia. Okay, so today we will discuss about nursing process. In that nursing process, I will teach you goal and plan. So what is goal and planning? Today we will learn. So this is nursing process, assessment, diagnosis, outcome and identification and planning. So outcome identification, that is goal, and planning, then implementation and evaluation. This is all about nursing process. Okay, so definition of planning. So according to Potter and Perry 2001, planning is a category of nursing behavior in which client-centered goals are established and interventions are designed to achieve the goals. Okay, so what it means to say that planning is a category of nursing behavior in which client-centered goals, a nurse set goals or establish goal on the basis of client's need and client's illness, and then we have to plan interventions. That means we have to give treatment on the basis of patient's disease condition to achieve that goals. Okay, planning involves decision making and problem solving. On the basis of planning, with the help of planning, we make decision and solve the patient's problem. It is the process of formulating client goal and designing the nursing interventions required to prevent, reduce or eliminate the client's health problem. Okay, so on the basis of goal in nursing intervention treatment, we can prevent, reduce or eliminate patient's disease condition or illness. Okay, next, types of planning. There are three types of planning. First, initial planning. Second one, ongoing planning. And third one, discharge planning. Okay, so what is initial planning? Planning which is done after the initial assessment. When patient comes in the hospital, so we have to assess the patient's condition or patient's whole body. Okay, so on the basis of patient's signs and symptoms, we have to make initial planning. After the assessment, immediately we make planning. Initial basis, we make planning. So that is initial planning. Next, ongoing planning. So what is ongoing planning? It is a continuous planning. When patient is admitted in the hospital, and day by day what we plan, what we give treatment to the patient, that is ongoing planning. And discharge planning. So what is discharge planning? Planning for the needs after discharge. Okay, when patient discharged from hospital, what on the basis of needs, patient's need, we have to plan of treatment of the patient and provide that treatment. We give medicine and some home remedies we can suggest to the patient. Some physiotherapy we can suggest to the patient after discharge. That is discharge plan. Okay. Next, planning process. So, what is planning process? Planning process includes setting priorities. Okay, so first we have to set priorities according to patient's priority, according to patient's symptoms, we have to plan our treatment. Okay, then establishing client's goal and desired outcome. After we see the priority of the patient, then we establish goals and outcome of the patient. Okay, we establish goals. So what we can, if patient having fever, so our goal is to reduce patient's fever, that is our goal. Okay, then selecting nursing interventions and activities. When patient having fever, so our goal is to reduce patient's fever, so what we can do for reduce patient's fever, we can give cold application. That is our nursing intervention. So we can select nursing intervention. Okay, so we will do cold sponge. Okay, so that is nursing intervention. We will give antipyretic medication. That is nursing intervention. So we select. I can choose. I can choose cold sponge or else antipyretic medication. Okay, and then writing individualized nursing intervention on the care plan, and then what I will give. If I will give antipyretic medication as per doctor's order, that I will write on the patient's care plan. Okay, if I will give cold sponge, so I'll write on the nursing care plan that I have given cold sponge to the patient. Okay, next. So first is setting priorities. The nurse begin planning by deciding which nursing diagnosis requires attention first, which second, and so on. Okay, so my patient having breathing difficulty and my patient having headache. Okay, so I will treat first breathing difficulty. If patient having headache and breathing difficulty, so I will treat breathing difficulty. I will put oxygen mask on the patient and switch on oxygen. I will try to provide oxygen to the patient, and then after I will give analgesic medication or diversional therapy for headache. Okay, then nurses frequently use Maslow hierarchy of needs when setting priorities. Okay, nurses use Maslow hierarchy when we are setting for priorities. Okay, so what is Maslow hierarchy? Okay, this is Maslow hierarchy pyramid. Okay, so first is physiological need, second one is safety needs, third one is love and belonging, fourth one is esteem, and fifth one is self-actualization. Okay, so this is the physiological needs. Basic needs, food, water, and shelter. This is the most basic need. Each and person want these needs. So we have to try to fulfill first. Priorly, we have to fulfill these physiological needs first, and then after we can see for other needs. Okay. Okay, establishing client's goal and desired outcome. Okay, first we do setting priorities. Okay, then after, second step is establishing client's goal and desired outcome. Okay, so after establishing priorities, the nurse set goals for each nursing diagnosis. Okay, now we decided that we will reduce or prevent breathing difficulty of patient. Okay, priority is set. So now we will set goal for each nursing diagnosis. Okay, so we will set goals. How we set goals? I have to reduce breathing difficulty of patient. This is my goal, so I have to reduce breathing difficulty. Then goals may be short term or long term. Okay, my patient having pneumonia, so my short term goal is to reduce breathing difficulty. Okay, to reduce coughing, to reduce sneezing, to reduce cold. This is my short term goal. So my long term goal is to reduce or eliminate pneumonia disease. Okay, this is my long term goal. Okay, nursing intervention. So what is nursing intervention? This is our third step. So nursing intervention is any treatment that a nurse performs to improve patient's health. Okay, so what is nursing treatment or intervention? So it is one kind of treatment that we are performing to improve patient's health and eliminate disease condition. Okay, then types of nursing intervention. So first, we see a nursing intervention, and these three are types of nursing intervention. Okay, independent intervention are those activities that nurse are licensed to initiate on the basis of their knowledge and skill. Okay, independent nursing intervention, dependent nursing intervention, and collaborative intervention. Okay, so what is independent nursing intervention? This is, we are licensed to do this condition. Okay, we cannot give a drug without doctor's order. Okay, we cannot give drug, any medication to the patient without doctor's permission. Okay, we can give cold sponge, we can give back care. This is our, based on our knowledge and skill, we are licensed to do this, but we cannot give antipyretic, analgesic, any medication without doctor permission. If doctor writes on their order, then we can administer in the patient. Okay. Second one is dependent nursing intervention. Are activities carried out under the orders or supervision of licensed physician. Okay. After patient's order, we can give medication or any surgery about any surgery. We can some treatment after doctor's permission, that is dependent. We are dependent on the doctor order. That independent, that we are not dependent on any healthcare team. We can independently give any medication. Any treatment. And that includes sponge bath or back care, okay, nail care, hair care. We can give this independently, this treatment. Okay. Third one is collaborative intervention. So what is collaborative intervention? Our action the nurse carries out in collaboration with other health team members. Okay. Physiotherapist, psychologist, counselor, these are other health team members. Okay. So we can collaborate with them, and then we will give treatment to the patient. Okay. Writing individualized nursing intervention. Okay, so how can we write nursing intervention? After choosing the appropriate nursing intervention, the nurse writes them on the care plan. Okay, I will reduce breathing difficulty of patient. Okay, so how can I reduce breathing difficulty of patient? I will put on oxygen mask and switch on the oxygen. Okay, this is the intervention. So I'll write intervention that I have given oxygen to the patient because my patient having breathing difficulty. Okay, nursing care plan is a written or computerized information about the client's care. Okay, this is the example of nursing process. How can we nursing process or care plan? How can we write care plan? Okay, first column is assessment. Second column is nursing diagnosis. Third column is goal. Then intervention. Then implementation. And then evaluation. Okay, so what is assessment? We assess the patient and we found that my patient having this care plan is about fever. Okay, so subjective data, the patient says that his body has warm, sweating and weakness. So we found that my patient having fever or pyrexia. Okay, so how after assessment we make nursing diagnosis. So what is nursing diagnosis? My patient having the diagnosis is altered body temperature related to disease condition, as evidenced by taking temperature. My patient having altered body temperature because of his or her disease condition. How can I found my patient having high temperature? I took patient's temperature, then I found that my patient having high temperature. Okay, so my goal is to reduce body temperature of patient. Okay, so what are the intervention of this goal? First, assess vital sign. I will take vital sign, in that I will take fever of patient, so I can give medication as per fever. Okay, then if my patient having high fever, so I will provide cold sponge. Then I will provide extra blanket if my patient having shivering, rigor, or my patient having cold. Provide keep and calm environment for around the patient. Provide healthy diet to the patient, so patient will recover quickly. Administer antipyretic medication as prescribed by doctor. When doctor prescribe antipyretic medication, then I will give to the patient. Then implementation. What we write on the intervention that we will implement on patient. That we will apply on the patient. And then evaluation. Then we will evaluate that my patient's condition is improved or not. This is all about nursing process. Okay, these all are the references. Thank you all of you.